I would say Vikrant was a unique ship, and even though today we have bigger and more sophisticated ships, I think there will never be another Vikrant.
Air Force is there to show the air power on land, but INS Vikrant showed the country's air power at sea.
Floating airfield, floating city, powerful weapon, you can use any of these adjectives to describe Vikrant.
In the context of Vikrant, no word fits better than pride.
Every time I went ashore and I was introduced, he's the pilot of Vikrant. It is not the pilot part, it is the Vikrant part.
Vikrant, in one word, mother.
Mother.
When the ship is at sea and the pilot's got a very small deck to land on, it's like coming on mother's arms, you know.
Flying from the aircraft carrier differentiates the men from the boys. Flying from the aircraft carrier.
The squadron which was based on Vikrant, that is the 300 squadron. In the early 60s, it was a very rare, it was the only fighter squadron in this part of the whole world to fly from an aircraft carrier. So the crest that they chose for it was a rare breed of tiger called the white tiger. On the ship, on Vikrant, the catapult was only 120 feet or so.
You don't have a runway. Please understand, there is no runway.
From zero speed, you would go to 130-140 miles per hour. Acceleration forces would drain the blood out of your head.
Because you are actually thrown out of the aircraft carrier. It is after you're thrown out that you catch hold of the control column and you start flying. And coming back to land on it. You don't have a big runway to land on. You got to pluck one of those wires. Otherwise, you are in the drink. You are in the sea. But now, in this excited atmosphere of a catapult takeoff and an arrestor landing, you have now superimposed the scenario of war on it. How to avoid the enemy radar. So you have to go low. You go hugging the water level. You know, go low. See the target. Pull up. Drop your bombs and your rockets onto the target, pull out, and then come back to the ship and land.
Therefore, all our training, you know, got evolved around an attack on Bangladesh. Chittagong and Khulna, they were pretty solid anti-aircraft fire.
Some bullets whizzed past the pilot's head. The windshields were shattered. They couldn't see outside.
When I said about, you know, we found that there were a couple of bullet holes in the wings and this, that and the other. Whilst we were flying, we never felt it.
I don't think it really mattered to, you know, the 300 squadron. Our job was to attack and we attacked.
It is amazing how the ship performed with a very determined ship and equally determined air crew.
So we always had that sense of pride in ourselves that we had learned to do something which was extremely difficult. Your flying had to be very accurate, your nerves had to be very strong. So that sense of pride stays with you always, even till today. I wear my squadron tie with a sense of pride.
It was war. You really need to be in it to understand it.
We've been told that Pakistan had declared war, they'd attacked our Air Force bases. A lot of refugees or people displaced from Bangladesh were flooding India.
War is not something we really look forward to. But if it had to happen, it had to happen, and we were there when it happened.
The major war, according to me, was before the war. Vikrant was not operational.
she was not completely battle worthy. She had serious problems with the engines, and many people felt that she should not take part in the war.
We are flying 1 hour a month, whereas we should be flying 20 hours a month. There was nothing right with the ship or the aircraft or the pilots.
And then we worked up. We worked up our armament, we worked up our navigation, we worked up everything. We got the squadron together. And then came the news that we actually were going to war.
And the ship sailed out and headed towards Bangladesh. Finally, we were attacking Chittagong from 70 miles, 80 miles.
You've got those bombs under your wings, you've got those rockets under your wings, you've got the control column with all the switches to drop your bombs and fire your guns.
Chittagong, we really, blasted there. Then there was Khulna, Chalna, which got attacked by us again over a period of time.
And people became wise to the fact that we heard Vikrant's name on the air. With that came more accurate firing against the aircraft.
When you see the bullets coming at you very slowly, and then suddenly, they go past you.
I had bullet holes, 7 or 8 of them, and which rendered the aircraft unsafe at high speeds.
We were also prepared. Yeah, our aircraft will get damaged. We will pull the blind, that means eject. A parachute will open. We will land anywhere. And anything can happen to us.
The environment on Vikrant was of heavy excitement.
When we came back from a sortie, we first went to the senior pilot or the squadron commander. When are you sending me up again?
The ground crew would not go down to the mess decks to sleep. They would sleep under their own aircraft. They wanted their aircraft to fly. 1,300 people on one ship and then escort ships along with it. I have one mission, and for which we have rehearsed again and again.
We wanted to make sure that we were there serving the nation. And actually, at the end of the day, it was serving the nation, serving the country.
From the stage when there were no pilots operational, no aircraft available, the ship itself limping, we won the war. And Vikrant played a no mean part at all, a very, very prominent part.
I had a mid-air collision.
I went nose down over the deck.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. I felt a huge judder. So I looked and I saw that my right wing was staring at me. My number 3 had gone into me in the left-hand turn. So I told flying control, I've had a mid-air. So they said, what? I remember the flying control guy. He says, Sina, सुबह पिया तो नहीं है अरे नहीं नहीं आई एम सीइंग दिस वाज 1200 फीट गोइंग डाउन टू 11 बट एज आई टर्न्ड माय विंग फेल ऑफ एंड आई वेंट इनटू अ स्पिन एट 650 फीट आई इजेक्टेड एंड गॉट आउट ऑफ द एयरक्राफ्ट सडनली फ्रॉम अ लॉट ऑफ नॉइज टोटल साइलेंस देन आई हिट द वाटर with my hand on my life vest. But I hit the water and it started getting dark. And got darker. And I said, hell, I should be seeing some light. It got darker. And I kept going down. Then I realized that I'm going down instead of. So I started doing my checks, starting from your feet round. And I realized that my hand had frozen due to the shock on my life vest. So I hadn't pulled it.
On the rollout, I found that the catapult was not operating to its full capacity. So I let the aircraft roll, hoping that by the end of the 108-foot run, I would get the airspeed that was required, which I didn't. Went nose down over the deck, and went into the water vertically, and the ship was moving forward at its maximum speed. In fact, the ship hit me as I went over and made my angle of entry into the water even steeper. I knew the ship was over me. The cockpit filled up with water. It was pretty dark inside, but I waited till I knew I had reached the correct depth. And on ejection, I came out, but as soon as I came out, I hit the bottom section of the ship. My helmet was smashed because of the suction effect of the ship. I was stuck to the ship and moving slowly back. We have big propellers at the back, but the captain of the ship, he took the right action. He went full astern on main engines. So that upset the suction effect, and I was released from the ship's side. The Vikrant carried out extensive trials, catapult trials in Bombay. And I did the full trials of the catapult myself, prove it before anyone else did any operations from the ship.
Came ashore, doctor said, bed. I said, no, I'm fine. He said, you're not fine, you rest. So he checked me out, he said, no injury. I came down today, the next day I was down, and the day after that, up again, flying first sortie. There's some things you can't forget.
I resigned because I felt that after having commanded a ship like Vikrant, I don't think I could ever get another appointment which would give me such high as this ship gave. When Naval Headquarters told me that I am being appointed as a captain and the ship will be decommissioned, it came as a shocker to me. I had to bid adieu to the entire fleet, to command, to the dockyard who served the ship. Then I thought of this idea of sending out a signal to everybody who were part of Vikrant during our operational days and maintenance time. So this was a signal which I sent out on the last day, which was addressed from Vikrant to the fleet, to the CNC of the command, to the dockyard admiral, and the ships which were there in the fleet at that time. And I'll read it out. In a few hours from now, I will come to rest. But in these 36 years, I think I did my best. For my fleet and the Navy, I earned great name. That's why they call me the Lady of Khulna fame. Now I'm going to bid adieu. And with all the good wishes coming from you, though I will be striking down the pennant from the main, I do hope, Vikrant, will be back soon again.
We were all convinced that something should have been done to save her.
My first reaction on Vikrant's being scrapped was of dismay.
I was very sad, very sad.
Sheer anger.
Now to send a ship to the scrapyard is almost like condemning a human being to, you know, execution or hanging or something like that.
We tried very hard, but
she's being put to rest, unsung and unhonored.
Well, when I read in the papers that Bajaj had decided to take some metal from Vikrant and incorporate it into a new product, I was quite thrilled to hear that. It was an armor-plated hull which could withstand the shock of a torpedo or a shell from a gun. So that was very valuable steel. So if even a little part of the steel is part of your motorbike, then you're a proud man. Be happy.
To the people who are going to ride the Vikrant, all I can say is I hope they ride it with the same pride and honor that the way we gave to the Vikrant ship. And I wish them all the best.